Hello friends, today we are discussing about electrical machines. Electrical machines have two type of broad classification. One is static machine, another is rotary machines. Static machine are those machine which has a stationary devices, which has no rotating devices. Another classification of static machine are AC machines and DC machines. AC machines are those machine which are applied by AC supply, and DC machines are those machine which are applied by DC supply. Now we'll see that AC machines having a classification is transformer, because transformer is a static machine which has a stationary armature, stationary device. Rotary machines are those machine which are revolving, which has a rotations of the armature, and one is fixed part. Rotary machine has two parts, AC machines and DC machines. Again, AC machines are already we discussed in static machines. AC machines are those machine which is applied by AC supply, and DC machine which are applied by the DC supply. AC machines has two classifications. One is AC generator and one other one is AC motor. AC generator, again two classifications, synchronous machines of generator and asynchronous machine of generator. Synchronous machine generator are those machine which is rotate at constant speed or fixed speed. Asynchronous generator are those generator which are having not fixed speed of prime mover. AC motor, again classification of synchronous motor and asynchronous motor. Synchronous motor, which output is always fixed or constant frequency and constant speed, we are saying as synchronous motor. Asynchronous motor, we also called as an induction motor, which is the rotor speed is not exactly equal to the stator speed. Now we'll see DC machines. DC machines having two component. One is DC motor. DC motor is output is speed and torque, and DC generator is output is electrical voltage and electrical current. Now we will see first chapter. We start with the transformer. Transformer, as the name says, that transformer is a static device which consists of two stationary circuits, is interlinked by common magnetic circuit. It has two windings. One is primary winding, and that means second is secondary winding. In between there is core, or we can give the supply voltage is here AC supply, and the secondary winding is connect to the load. So current start from primary winding will be I1, and current will be at load side will be I2, and this is called as a core. So it has two windings. This is a primary winding which is always connected to AC supply, and this is a secondary winding which is always connected to electrical load. So generally transformer having two electrical connections, and between there is a one core, and that is called as a magnetic core. The physical representation of transformer is like this. This is a rectangular core which is made up of CRGO material with silicon steel, and it has two supply. One supply is goes to the electrical primary supply, and that is called AC supply, and that is the load. So this is the rectangular core, and that is a magnetic core, and it is called as a yoke. So this is called a limb. So transformer having the two limbs and two yokes. So this is the complete magnetic path where the flux is produced. So this is the transformer having a common magnetic circuit which has one electrical circuit in the primary side and electrical circuit in the secondary side is a load circuit. So let's see, transformer is a static device which transforms the one voltage from one level to another level. So again we will see from this diagram, we will see that the level of voltage is changed from primary to secondary. Suppose primary voltage is V1, and secondary voltage. So we can say the change of voltage is happened in the transformer by changing number of turns, and as per proportional to E proportional to N. So we can say E1 by E2 is equal to n1 by n2, and we can say v1 by v2. So from this relationship, we can say voltage is changed from primary winding to secondary winding, or secondary winding to primary winding. So this voltage can be changed from high level side of primary to low level side of load voltage, or low level voltage supply from high level of load side. If V1 is more than V2, we can say this is the step down transformer. If V2 is more than V1, we can say step up transformer. So as we see here from next slide, that we see here that next slide is types of transformer. We'll see here a step down transformer and a step up transformer. So as per this relationship, the step up transformer means the load side voltage is more than supply voltage, and the step down transformer is supply voltage is more than the load voltage. Next is EMF equation of transformer. So EMF equation is decided by this relationship, where E phi m is equal to maximum flux and T is number of turns and F is the frequency. So from this relationship, we can say phi m is constant, F is constant, so we can say E is proportional to T. Sometimes we denote it number of turns by N also, so that is equal to T. So we can say E is proportional to N. So from this relation, we can see that voltage will be changed according to number of turns in the windings. This is the voltage ratio and turns ratio of transformer. V1 by V2 is equal to N1 by N2. As we see from the relation, E is proportional to N. So N1 by N2 is equal to I2 by I1 is equal to K. So why this voltage and current are inversely proportional? Because of power is equal to VI. So V is inversely proportional to I. So we can say if V is increased, I will decrease. And as we increase, number of turns is also increased. So from this relation, we can say this is the relation of the transformer turns ratio, and K is the turns ratio, or we can say sometimes transformation ratio. So today we discuss about transformer. Now we'll see the application of transformer. Transformer used to change the voltage or current of a device, electric power systems. It is used for impedance matching in power systems. It is used in a coupling device also. It is used for isolating purpose. Because there is one electrical circuit, another electric circuit, between is magnetic circuit. So that will isolate the transformer from the other devices. This is also used for measurement of voltage and current in instrument transformer. It is also used for high voltage AC and high voltage DC transmissions, for the back-to-back connections from step down the voltage, step up the voltage. Sometimes we require the transformer. So it's all about transformer we have discussed. Thank you.